Melas ini, it means Melas about to be cooking. And hari ini aku bakalan bikin the crunchiest, the crispiest, the most juicy. Nggak tahu juga sih kalau ini juicy atau enggak, but paling crispy, tercrispy, tergaring, terkriuk-kriuk. Iya, ini adalah salah satu snack yang sangat amat populer di Indonesia. And it's super duper easy, super duper gampang untuk dibikin. We only butuh kita hanya butuh 3 ingredient, yaitu makaroninya, tepung serbaguna, seasoning favorit kamu. Let's go to the kitchen. Yes. That was so smooth. I know hari ini penampakanku seperti some kind of hewan dari laut, perhaps kepiting or a lobster, I know. Tapi ini, it's a bang emergency. But yeah, so macaroni henge. Kenapa? Henge? Did I just say macaroni henge? So Mimi Ana gave my family a couple of snacks dari Indonesia, aka at Dapur Mimi Ana, the person who makes the best cireng di Belanda. Salah satunya macaroni ngehe and bakso aci juga. Kalau kalian pengen lihat aku bikin bakso acinya itu, please comment down below, because to be honest, aku belum pernah makan bakso aci. Seblak udah, tapi bikin sendiri belum pernah. Tapi kalau bakso aci, belum pernah makan, belum pernah bikin. So ya, yeah, kalau kalian pengen aku bikin itu, let me know in the comments below. But yeah, so makaroni ngehe, terus aku makan lagi, terus aku jadi kangen makaroni ngehe. Walaupun aku pasti yakin my Italian great grandpa ngelihat cicitnya bikin makanan ini dengan pasta, probably like, Mella, what do you do with the pasta? Simple, cepat, kilat, nikmat. Yes, makaroni ngehe. Aku kebanyakan bacot.
Okay guys, so I have about setengah bungkus dari makaroninya tadi.
And also, aku udah boiling water. And basically the steps untuk mahenya ini is really simple. You just boil the macaroni and then abis itu didiamkan dulu. Then we coat them pakai tepung serbagunanya and then we fry them. So, aku aku kira what the fuck. But so I got this tip. Jadi aku nonton salah satu YouTube video buat tutorial bikin mahe, and dia cerita kalau waktu itu tuh pernah dia coba bikin mahenya tuh tanpa ngerebus, jadi makaroninya mentah kayak gitu terus langsung digoreng, and it turned out to be not good. Although aku lihat ada beberapa video yang bikinnya kayak gitu and it was a success, so aku nggak tahu masalahnya di mana, but aku mau mending play it safe aja. So aku sekarang ngerebus, and then after direbus we're gonna continue with the coating and stuff, so I'll see you. Airnya udah mulai mendidih, so sekarang aku mau masukin macaroninya ke dalam situ kayak gini. Yes. And kita mau masak itu sampai it's like maybe kind of al dente ya. Pokoknya jangan terlalu matang karena nanti kan bakal digoreng. I mean it's okay sih. Bodo amat mau al dente mau terlalu matang, yang penting jadi. Okay. Maybe jangan kelamaan, like don't let it sit like 10 minutes or 15 minutes. We don't want to do that, but like yang penting matang. Okay guys. So, makaroninya udah matang. And now I'm gonna strain the macaroni. So watch. Yes, look. Ooh, oh, I don't like it. Now kita ngebiarin ini. We let it sit sampai dingin, and then baru kita lanjut. We just put the tepung serba. Serbaguna just dimasukin gitu and then abis itu langsung goreng. Simple as that. I don't even think this video bakal nyampe 10 menit. I don't even think. Ini gampang banget dibikinnya. Ini proses bikinnya aja sekarang aku lama soalnya aku nge-filming, tapi it's so easy. Seharusnya tidak nunggu makaroninya dingin dan kering dulu, but we just have to wait until the water was strained. So basically kalau udah kayak begini and it's still smoking, panas, it's okay to use them karena itu bakal ngebantu supaya tepungnya nempel sama makaroninya. So yeah, that's what we're gonna do now. Okay, so here's my tepung serbaguna and I'm gonna put it in dikit-dikit and then stir with my hand because that's easier. I don't like the feel of it though, so I'm gonna use a silicone spatula. Never mind. I use this silicone spatula. Soalnya rasanya gimana ya, kayak kan empuk gitu kan, terus kayak jadinya it comes under my nails and I don't like that feeling. So yeah, giniin aja terus. Okay, can you see? It's like super duper white gara-gara ditepungin. That's what we wanna have. And now kita ngebiarin sampai dingin supaya tepungnya meresap masuk ke dalam makaroninya. And then baru kita bakal anuin, apa namanya, gorengin. Okay, this is so easy. Aduh, jangan kecepetan dulu ngomongnya. Because last time aku ngomong kayak gitu tentang cireng and I failed making cirengnya. It took me 2 days buat bikin cirengnya. So I'm gonna shut my mouth sekarang and stop saying this is so easy, this is so easy. Soalnya, you know, kalau terlalu pede, it's almost like God doesn't want me buat pede. He wants me insecure always. So sekarang I have my panci dengan minyak right here. I know my stove looks like a fucking mess, but you know what? Cleaning the kitchen is not always easy. Here is the pasta yang sudah kita pakaikan tepung serba warna, serba guna. Bitch, I keep forgetting it's a bag. But yeah, aku mau masukin ini dulu and then I'll show you guys. Sekarang this is kind of how it's looking right now. Di dalamnya, okay. And kita mau ngegorengin ini tuh until pastanya tuh jadi kayak warna agak kecoklatan tapi nggak coklat tua ya, because that means you burnt the motherfucker. We want it to be like just coklat. Pokoknya coklat, we don't want it to be tetap warnanya sama because that means belum terlalu garing yet. So yeah, we're just gonna wait and I will catch back with you guys kalau udah nyampai the desired result. It's been like about 10 minutes and see, look at the color. Warnanya sekarang kayak begini ya, agak golden, dan kalau kamu pegang ini juga teksturnya tuh udah keras gitu. Kamu pencet sekeras apapun juga kayak gak bakal benyek gitu. So now I'm gonna turn off the heat and I'm gonna transfer it and I'm gonna do that with the rest too. Look at this. Oh my god. Sekarang kita tinggal kasihin bumbu ya ke makaroninya. So this is what I'm gonna do. I have this apa? Jadi aku tuh enggak nemu bon cabe di local supermarket. Aku of course enggak ada bon cabe. I don't even know if you guys can see me sekarang. But yeah, I tried looking di local supermarket aku and I tried to look for bon cabe, but obviously enggak ada kalau di local supermarket. Aku kalau mau nemuin bon cabe harus ke supermarket Asia, which is a little bit far away from where I live. So, I got these spice blends. Ini yang satu nih mac and cheese, terus yang satunya ini pokoknya intinya pedas. And I'm just gonna mix these two up. Soalnya rasa favorit aku dari macaroni ngehe is the cheese, tapi yang pedas level 3 kalau nggak salah, keju pedas level 3. So I'm just gonna try and make that. Obviously rasanya nggak bakal sama, tapi intinya pokoknya seperti itu ya. And yang penting ini macaroni ngehe nya ada rasanya ya kan. Iya, aku langsung masukin spicesnya di makaroninya padahal makaroninya baru aja dikeluarkan dari minyak ya, tapi justru itu yang bakal ngebantu supaya spicesnya lengket sama makaroninya. And now we're just gonna shake this baby up pretty much. That was literally all we had to do. Sekarang aku mau ngebiarin dulu, aku mau mandi, siap-siap kerja, and then sebelum kerja kita bakal taste test. Hey guys, kembali lagi sama aku, and sekarang aku baru pulang dari kerjaan. I decided aku mau nunggu ngicipin makaroni ngehe-nya setelah aku pulang dari kerjaan, because aku takutnya kalau tadi aku udah cicipin, takutnya agak kecepetan, makaroni ngehe-nya masih terlalu panas. Soalnya semakin lama ditunggu, semakin, you know, it's gonna harden eventually, walaupun udah keras setelah digoreng, but like we're just gonna leave it, you know. So here is the macaroni ngehe. And also akhirnya aku tadi nitipin ke mamaku, ma, kalau mama sempat pulang kerja beliin bon cabe, because aku takutnya kurang, you know, karena tetep aja spices Belanda versus Indo, takutnya kurang pedes buat aku. So here is the final result of my macaroni ngehe.
Then let me open up and show you guys the bee better.
Ta-da! Oopsie! Look. Okay. And now it's time buat ngerasain the taste.
Ribet banget ngambil makaroni ngehe doang, astaga.
Here we go.
Kalau aku udah joget-joget kayak begitu, artinya sukses. Yoi. Oh my god, I can't believe I made my own macaroni ngehe. This is very good, you guys. I know for a fact, bumbu-bumbu yang ada di Indonesia yang kalian bisa beli, yang aku nggak bisa beli, yang antara belum diimpor ke sini sama yang memang nggak ada di sini, guys. Kalau bisa, I mean of course, kalian bisa beli sendiri di macaroni ngehe-nya. But if you want to try and make your own, play with the flavors, bitch! Flavor soto, Betawi, or whatever. Play! Success! Easy banget buat dibikin. If you need a quick snack, if you want a snack at home, ini gampang banget buat dibikinnya. Menurut aku kepedesan, okay? Karena bun cabenya level 10. So I'm gonna close up today's video. Hope you guys enjoyed. And I will see you guys di video masak-masak berikutnya. Adios, amigos! Ciao! Mela out!